إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أما بعد. كل إنسان له ميزان وكل ميزان له كفتان، في الأولى كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى وسنة نبيه، وفي الثانية أعمال العبد وأخلاقه وسلوكه. Every person has a scale, and every scale has two sides. In one side, Quran and Sunnah. On the other side, your actions, your manners, and your behavior. ومقدار هذه الأخلاق هو قربك أو بعدك عن كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى وسنة نبيه. How good and how perfect you are in your dealings and in your manners and behavior, it's how close you are to what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said and what His Messenger Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said. So it's an issue of knowledge. We all say we follow Quran and Sunnah, but what do you know about the Quran and Sunnah? And when you hear a hadith or an ayah, how much you know about it? Do you understand it well? Because a lot of people memorize and understand one side of that, and then they start making rules and judging and concluding, and there are many other ahadith and ayat that directs that hadith to how to understand it. And we know the religion, it's not one-way street where one issue, it has a perfect meaning. Few of that are there, ayat al-muhkamat, lakin ghalib al-deen mutashabihat fi al-Qur'an. والمتشابه يرد إلى المحكم وإلى أحاديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو ما صح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، فهو الفيصل في الفهم. When you look at the Quran, for instance, you have definitive ayat that, you know, one way of understanding, you cannot have a possibility of another way. And the majority of the ayat, you can have different understanding. And how do you understand those ayat? You refer it to the definitive ayat and to what is authentic from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So people nowadays, يعني هؤلاء اللي بيشككوا في الإسلام أو بيهدموا في الإسلام ينحوا السنة ولا يتكلموا إلا عن القرآن، وهذا هو القرآن وهذا هو كلام الله وهذا هو الأصل وهذا هو الصحيح، وكذلك حتى ينحوا القرآن، وبدأوا حتى يشككون في صحيح البخاري وصحيح مسلم. وكلنا يعلم أن الأمة أجمعت على أنهما أصح كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى، أصح الكتب بعد كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى. When you look at majority of people now, you listen to scholars or so-called scholars, but in reality they have the knowledge to go against the religion. And you have some people that so many people listen to nowadays, يعني emerging people who are claim specializing in a certain area, and the whole goal is to focus on the Quran, which sounds good and appears to be good, but in it is buried no sunnah. يعني a person who keeps telling you Quran, يعني more than likely he doesn't want you to refer to Sunnah. They only refer to the Sunnah when it's agreeing exactly with what they want. All the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but if they don't mentally agree with it, they tell you, you don't leave the Quran for the Sunnah. And who told you that you leave the Quran to the Sunnah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنَزَّلْنَا إليك الذكرى لتبين للناس ما نزل إليهم. The Quran is revealed, so the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will tell people how it is understood and what it means. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred us to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is, it happens a lot. So be careful from those people that, yani, you hear tafsir. Yesterday, some sister sent me a video for someone talking about the son of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, and Hur al-Ain, and even the discussion is useless. Yani, to come and discuss Hur al-Ain is like an Arabic word that applies for men and women. To conclude what? Women have Hur al-Ain. I don't think a woman in the right mind would look forward to that, to be honest with you. A decent woman will not be excited and happy to go to Jannah for Hur al-Ain. I don't think any woman, yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it created them with the haya and created them with yani, they are created from Adam alayhi salam, from Hawa, and Hawa from Adam alayhi salam. So this is one, they're trying to just basically drag people to the notion and to what's going around that women and men are equal. The only difference is probably the biological differences. Other than that, they want to make him just exactly what man gets, woman gets. What woman gets, man gets. Even though logic rejects that, the religion rejects that, taste rejects that, lust and love and all that rejects that, everything rejects that. But this is one aspect, because they want to go along with the flow. And Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, his son, like his son, is kafir, right? Died as a kafir. No, he is not kafir. Why? Because this is not his son, this is his cousin or his uncle. Yani, imagine how, when you try to understand the tafsir of the Quran, isolated from the sunnah and isolated from the ulama who are yani, endowed with knowledge. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like their justification, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised Nuh alayhi salam that he will save his family. And when when his son was drowned, Prophet Nuh alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Oh Allah, you promised me." And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "He is not from your family." What is so obvious? Because the brotherhood and the love and everything is based on Islam. And Islam and the religion is stronger than the blood relationship between one brother and another. And we know a story, many stories from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, when one of the Sahaba, yani I think I talked about it the other day, one of the Sahaba, he wants to ransom his son. I mean, Mus'ab ibn Umair radiallahu anhu, when the Muslims captured him, and then he used the name of his brother, so they were easy with him. What did his brother do? He said, tie him stronger and get money from his mom, because he's not his brother. And he said it, he's not my brother, because brotherhood is religion. Religion is really what ties you with that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَى إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَى. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him he's not from your family, meaning he's a disbeliever, he's not a believer. I promised I will save you and your family. Only the believers will be saved in that event. And that's why he said, يَا بُنَيَّ ارْكَبْ مَعْنَا وَلَا تَكُنْ مَعَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Ride with us and don't be with the disbelievers. So whether you are my son or my father, you're going to go. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects that religion. Always you have people to defend that. And you have another brother giving some tafsir about Surah Al-Mulk, in some tafsir that if you look at every authentic classical tafsir, there's nothing even related to it. It's not related. And people are fascinated and dazzled because you have stories and you have things. And you know, when you find someone hears a hadith in Bukhari and he tells you, uqsim billah law anna ar-ruwa يعني أقسموا لي أن هذا الحديث صحيح لا أصدقه. ومن هم الرواة؟ صحابة رضي الله عنهم. And he said, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if the narrators of this hadith swears that this is from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will not believe it because it doesn't get to my brain. So you need to protect yourself. You need to protect yourself by focusing on the sunnah. Focusing on the sunnah, the Quran and the sunnah. One of the scholars said the Quran is in need for the sunnah more than the sunnah in need for the Quran. Yani if we have the sunnah, we will function properly as Muslims and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. But if we have the Quran by itself, we will not. And we know that. I mean, we are here praying. Who designed the prayer and the rak'at and the sunnah and fard and where to pray and how to pray? Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Did the Quran show you how to pray or tell you how to pray or how to make hajj? These are logical, but when people address the general people who don't have the knowledge, naturally they dazzle people. You have many of those around. So let's take one look at one hadith just for us here, away from the topic. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha du'iya ahadukum ila ta'am wa kana sa'iman falyakul falyad'u wa in kana muftiran falyut'am." If someone invites you for food and you are fasting, you make dua for the person. And if you are not fasting, you eat. So someone invites you, you go. That's the sunnah. Don't come and force the person to break his fast because you cite one hadith and you tell him you break your fast because you have to answer the da'wah. And this is optional. And this is based on the person who is inviting you. Would he understand? Would he appreciate? Or he's going to get really upset and you're going to disappoint him. You weigh it. But the Prophet ﷺ told you how it is. Make dua for him if you are fasting. He didn't say break your fast. He said, make dua for him. So if you have other hadith that tells you invite, if someone invites you, it's his right, you go. And one time, you know, some of the Sahaba came and they were fasting and broke his fast and all that. That's another choice. So to combine the two hadith and to understand them, if the person is okay with it, then it should be okay to continue. I would tell the brother, yani, if you forgive me today, I'm fasting. But of course, if he is a stubborn brother, and he is a brother who doesn't care but for himself, he's going to tell you, no, the sunnah, it's the sunnah. No, it's not the sunnah. No, it's the sunnah. The Prophet ﷺ said so and so. Also, when you talk about talking akhlaq, remember we said how much akhlaq you have, it's how close you are to the Quran and the sunnah. You have hadith that the Prophet ﷺ told us, كفى بالمرء كذبا أن يحدث بكل ما سمع. Sufficient lies that you talk about everything you hear. Can you imagine how much information you hear daily? Can you imagine when you pass that without verification, without purification, how many lies in there and how many problems you will have? And that's what people do. And unfortunately, they do it in media. So they pass it to people left and right, and it goes to everyone, and people believe it. And I always cite the slander of Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anh against Aisha radiallahu anha. He never doubted her, and he never believed what happened, but he heard it, and he said it. It's like I say something, and you say, Sheikh Hassan said such and such, without you verifying it. I am a slander, you become a slander, simply because you carried my words without verification. And we always know, and we all know, إن جاءكم فاسقٌ بنبأ فتبينوا. Always you have to. So many of us don't pay attention to that, and they talk and they pass information, and they think that when you say, Wallahi, I don't know if this is true or not, but I heard such and such and such. You fell in it. You fell in this hadith. Sufficient lies, you relate everything you hear. And we know that a lot of people try to comfort themselves when they backbite. Wallahi, inshallah, this is not backbiting. But, you know, I would say it to his face. Well, go ahead and say it to his face. Why are you saying it behind his back? So sometimes you know yourself, but you try to comfort yourself. Because many of us, brothers and sisters, really, we cannot spend our time without talking. It's fun. It's fun to talk and to listen. The only way that you can have a conversation beneficial is to talk about religion. And how many people talk about religion or things related to religion? You can talk business, but you connect it with religion. You can talk about anything. People don't like to talk about those. So what else left? You're going to have to start talking. I heard, and he said, and she said. So be careful with that, and make sure that your hasanat always there. Because the day of judgment, if you take a quote and you pass it on the media, it goes to thousands and probably millions, and God knows how many years it's going to be in there before you meet at the day of judgment. So don't talk about everything you hear, and at the same time, be honest, and at the same time, make sure you balance between responding to your brother and taking care of his feelings, and always stick to the sunnah. You go to Jannah. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. ما برن ما برن رن